Hello.
DIY Play-Doh at home. This is what a thermocol would taste like. So we are doing something super fun in the kitchen today. I'll be testing out some viral baking hacks that I've seen on the internet, and I'll be testing them in my kitchen. To save you some trouble and to let you know if they actually work or not, let's get started. The first hack that I'm testing is a DIY bundt cake hack, which I think is going to be super useful if you don't have a bundt pan. All you need is a circular pan. I'm going to place a can of condensed milk in the center and then pour my chocolate cake batter around it. Now, two cool things are going to happen here. We are going to make a bundt cake without actually using a bundt pan, and this condensed milk is going to cook in the oven and become a dulce de leche glaze. I'm super excited to see how this turns out. I'm going to bake this for about 35 to 40 minutes. So I put the cake in the oven, and while I'm super confident about achieving that bundt shape, I am slightly skeptical about the dulce de leche, because whenever I cook condensed milk to make dulce de leche on the stove, it takes at least 3 hours there. But the cake batter shouldn't take more than 30 minutes, so I'm not sure if that much time is enough for the condensed milk to achieve that rich, deep color and cook down completely. So we'll find out in a while. So the top layer of the condensed milk is completely burnt, and I'm going to try and find out if we have dulce de leche on the inside. Eeks. This looks disgusting. And also the burnt particles have now gotten combined with the condensed milk and it's become a gluggy mess. However, I'm still going to demold my cake and see if we at least got that bundt shape on point. Abhi sam darling, expectation versus reality ka comparison to show you what I was hoping for and what this has turned out to be. This cake, as you can already see, is the most unappetizing looking cake ever, to say the least. But this hack ko I'll give a 5 out of 10, because one half of it, which is achieving the bun shape, does work. I would say that you use an already empty can of condensed milk to get the bun shape, because clearly the dulce de leche glaze looks like vomit. The next hack is something that I'm super excited about. We'll be baking brownies in a paper bag in a microwave in just 10 minutes. All you need to do is to take your brownie batter and transfer it into your brown paper bag. I'm also adding some walnuts on top. And then all we need to do is to just pack it and pop it into the microwave for 10 minutes. So this is ready for the microwave, and you'll get to see this video if I don't burn my kitchen down. So this was in the microwave for 7 minutes and it smells disgusting. The kitchen smells disgusting. And mujhe pehle pata ki jala hua hai, but I'm still going to look at it. Okay. It's kind of spread out and become it. Oh, sorry. Oh god, it smells disgusting. And it's become like a brownie, but it's a extremely weirdly burnt, disgusting smelling brownie, and this is also extremely greasy. And now I would like to invite Ride and Ria to come and taste this brownie. Let's do the taste test. Yeah. Cheers. Oh god, aisa lag raha hai ki humne kaha ki chalo aaj hum coal khayenge. Actually koila kha rahe hum log, aisa lag raha hai. And kuch chocolate ka taste nahi hai. And it's actually like guys, इससे अच्छा like 10 minutes की जगह just spend 30 minutes of your life and make a brownie. मतलब that 20 minutes extra is going to be worth your time. So on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to rate the brown paper bag brownie a -1. The best way to store this brownie is to put it in a bin. Now the next hack that I'm testing seems like a savior in the situation where you forget to line and grease your pan. So to test this hack, I've made a cake in my lowest quality cake pan, and I've not greased it or lined it. And now what I'm going to do is place it over a steaming hot bowl of water, and the steam is supposed to actually help me release the cake from the pan and make the demolding easier. And now I'm going to flip this upside down. Hello. Oh, not bad. Honestly, I'm super impressed by this hack because इस केक पैन से even after I grease it properly, केक easily नहीं निकलता है, but this has come out like magic so easily and it's also looking super smooth and nice. So I'm going to give this hack a total 10 out of 10. Next up, I'm testing two piping hacks without using any piping nozzles. We're going to try and achieve some beautiful piping designs using only a piping bag, some tape and a safety pin. To make a ruffle nozzle, I'm simply going to snip one end of my piping bag like so. This is so cool because I love using my ruffle nozzle and I use it so many times, but I never thought that I could actually achieve the exact same design without actually using a nozzle. I would like to rate this hack 100 on 10. For the next hack, I'm going to tape the tip of my piping bag like this and then use a safety pin to make holes here. I don't know how I feel about this particular design, but the hack works and it's actually pretty cool how this looks. So even this piping hack gets a 10 out of 10 from me. Time for the next hack, and this is a very simple two ingredient ice cream cake which just uses ice cream and self-raising flour. I'm using strawberry ice cream to make my cake today, and since I don't have self-raising flour, I'll be using maida, which is all-purpose flour along with some baking powder. All you need to do is to melt your ice cream, combine it with maida and baking powder, give everything a good mix, and your very quick and simple cake batter is ready. Now, the last time that I made something similar was by combining Oreos and milk, and that gave me a very great cake, so I'm hoping that this hack works as well. The batter looks slightly weird and the thought of only combining ice cream and maida is weirder, but we'll find out how this turns out. So the ice cream cake is ready, and besides this weird bump on the side, I feel like it looks pretty normal. I really like the color and it smells like hot ice cream, which I'm not a big fan of, but we are going to demold this now and see how it turns out. ऐसा लग रहा है कि किसी ने मुझे कच्चे मैदे को बस ice cream में मिलाकर दे दिया है. It tastes disgusting. It tastes like, मैंने कभी thermocol taste नहीं किया, but I feel like this is what a thermocol would taste like. DIY Play-Doh at home. Guys, to be honest, मुझे इस ice cream cake से ज्यादा expectations नहीं थी, तो if my expectations were here, the end result was here, which is why I am going to give this hack a 0 out of 10, unfortunately. I had so much fun testing and trying these hacks in my kitchen, and while half of them were absolutely disastrous, I still found a couple of them which I could actually use in my kitchen. If you enjoyed watching this video, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And if there are any other crazy hacks out there on the internet that you'd want me to try, leave them in the comments below. I'll see you guys next week with another video. Until then, happy baking.